ARM TechCon 2016, and you're the Vice President of Technology?
I'm a Vice President of Technology for the Media Processing Group, which is graphics, video, and display, and I'm also now the Vice President of Technology for the Imaging and Vision Group. So I'm going to campaign for a new job title. I'm going to be the VP of Technology for Pixels.
For Pixels? So there's huge things, and it's difficult to grasp how much there is going to happen with this field right there. It's huge, right?
Yes, there's so much happening. It's a time, you know, everybody keeps predicting that the industry is about to get staid and boring and, you know, nothing's going to happen, and nothing could be further from the truth. There's so much innovation going on.
Because right now I'm filming with a camera, it's 4K, that's cool, but there's a room and you could maybe have phones like recognize space and 3D, they'll map the whole world again, and there'll be like street view for real. VR is crazy.
Yes, I mean, I think next year you'll probably be doing this on your mobile phone.
Next year. So this year, in May, you acquired Apical.
Yes.
So what does Apical do?
So I went out on a worldwide search for the best in imaging and computer vision, and I found it in Apical, which is a great UK engineering success story. They're in a place called Loughborough, which is a couple of hours' drive north from Cambridge. And they do. They have three main products. They have an image signal processor, so an ISP, which converts the data you get out of a camera sensor into something you and I might recognize as an image and cleans it up. They have a display engine, a local tone mapping display engine, which fits neatly inside the Mali display processor product. And they also have a computer vision engine, which does object recognition. So you provide it with some example data of, say, people, and it recognizes people.
So we're talking about camera, we're talking about displays, and we're talking about something that's not CPU, GPU compute, but it's supplementing it?
It's a dedicated engine. So the computer vision engine is a fixed function object detection engine. Doesn't use the GPU at all.
So it's low power?
So it's extremely low power, yes. So it works at full frame rate and 4K resolution, and you can run it at that in extremely low power for portable battery-powered devices.
So what's possible to do with computer vision? Is like is an area on the SoC is going to be in the future chips, right?
Yes, that's right.
And there will be an area that can be programmed to compute the vision?
The engine we have is not directly programmable. It's configurable. You provide it with example images, and it will detect those images. So the first use case is people and faces and hands and, you know, people sort of in various poses, so that it will recognize people, because, you know, people take up different shapes at different times. You know, they turn this way and that way, and they look different.
It sounds a little bit like magic. Is it going to be like ways to improve that a lot? Or is it possible that some of your customers will integrate it and make it like just amazing from the first generation?
So there's so many different things you can do once you find, and looking at an image, you found people in it. So you might use it, for example, to control your video encoder. So having found the faces in the image, you will encode the faces using many more bits, higher quality, than the background behind you. And so the image will look good. Your video will just look pleasingly better. You might be using it to control some services. So you might have it surveilling a train station platform. It counts the number of people who are standing on the platform, and when it gets above a certain limit, they say, no, this is not safe. We need to close the doors and stop people flooding onto the platform. You can have it monitoring the elderly. So, you know, if they're walking around and moving around, that's all fine. If they've fallen over on the floor and they don't seem to be moving, you know, you raise the alarm. So there's good things it can do. It's not all Big Brother.
There's baby monitors, there's
absolutely
pet monitors.
Pet monitors. I reckon there's loads of money to be made in pet monitors.
And this is going to revolutionize the IP camera business, right?
Completely. So one of our first customers for this IP is the IP camera market.
And this is something we absolutely need with the growing amount of IoT devices, and there's not unlimited bandwidth.
No, you need to selectively. You need to be able to do this detection on device, because you can't afford the power and the bandwidth to send all this lot over the internet up to some server 3,000 miles away, have it processed on the server and send the results back. That's just not going to work. We can't afford the power or the bandwidth for that. So the intelligent devices at the edge of the network are going to have to be doing this processing themselves.
And hopefully very soon we have a Mali G71 devices coming out. Is going to be pretty powerful, right?
Yes, so you've seen a press release in the last few weeks. HiSilicon have announced the Kirin chip, the 960, containing the Mali G71. And I believe that Huawei have also announced phones containing that chip.
So that's going to be there's going to be lots of stuff happening also on the Chromebooks area, maybe on the doing work with laptops, right?
Absolutely. Our partners haven't announced those plans yet, but yes, we are working hard in that area.
So there's some teams optimizing.
Always optimizing.
And using the GPU compute, finally using it to optimize everything in Android and
yes.
Everywhere.
Yes.
All right, so it's exciting times at ARM. It's going to be
tremendously
fun.
Exciting times. I've had one of the most busy, exciting years of my career. It's just nonstop. And then, of course, you know, recent events with SoftBank, you couldn't have predicted any of this, but it's great.
So exciting, and looking forward to future 2017. Is going to be fun.
I think so. I think we are entering a new phase at ARM now, whereby you know you've only begun to see what we can do. I think we're going to go on to amazing things.
And it's been announced that the workforce has to expand. So you're looking for talents to.
I'm taking CVs. Do you have CVs to give me of great people? I'm hiring. We're hiring experienced GPU architects, video architects, imaging architects. Send me your CVs.